back to the City Stay and True to Yourself podcast. It's your host, it's your boy Tex Wambui. This is the podcast that deep dives into weird topics or any type of topics. But this week in this season, we're going to be focusing on global economic trends, trade relations, and the pursuit of equitable access to higher education. So in today's episode, I will embark on a journey to understand Kenya's rising influence in the global economy. I will explore its economic significance, trade relations with powerful nations, regional implications, and the ongoing efforts to bridge African-American history, international administration, and East African development. So, join me as I unravel the captivating story of Kenya's growth and its commitment to shaping a better future. So first, I will start off by talking about Kenya's importance to the global economy. Kenya is located in East Africa. It has emerged as a regional economic powerhouse. Its robust economy is fueled by key sectors such as agriculture, manufacturing, services, and technology. With a population of over 50 million and a growing middle class, Kenya offers immense market potential. Kenya's significance to the global economy lies in its role as a major transportation and logistics hub in East Africa. The country's infrastructure developments, including roads, railways, and airports, have improved connectivity and facilitated trade within the region. According to Rigema, in an article in a journal published in 2020, digital technology has played a crucial role in Kenya's economic transformation, enabling more efficient processes and enhancing political and social economic transformation in the East African community region. So, now let's kind of transition to the recent trade relations and partnerships. Kenya has actively engaged with influential nations such as the United States, the European Union, and others, fostering robust trade relations and partnerships. In recent years, Kenya has pursued trade agreements and partnerships that have bolstered its economy. For instance, the Kenya-US Free Trade Agreement aims to enhance bilateral trade between the two countries, creating opportunities for Kenyan businesses. Kenya exports a variety of products, including agricultural goods like tea, coffee, flour, and fresh produce, as well as manufactured goods such as textiles and apparel. The country also imports machinery, petroleum products, vehicles, and electronic equipment. Just on a side note, I wish and I hope one day somebody can create the first car in Kenya. We can manufacture cars there. That would be so cool to say it's made in Kenya. Next, I would like to just talk about the future impacts of the Port of Mombasa as it relates to the nation. So one crucial element driving Kenya's trade and economic growth is the Port of Mombasa, a key gateway for international trade in the region. The Port of Mombasa, located along the Indian Ocean coastline, serves as a vital trade route. It's also been a really important trade route historically, back to like the Silk Road, Arabian spice trade, all that stuff. Anyways, recent developments and expansions have increased its capacity, allowing for larger cargo volumes and more efficient operations. This growth positions Kenya as a key player in regional and global trade. The port's strategic location enhances regional connectivity, attracting investments and fostering economic growth, not only for Kenya, but also for neighboring countries. Farouk, in an article in 2018 in a research study, highlighted the implications of Kenya's involvement in the 21st century maritime Silk Road, which strengthens China-Africa relations and opens up new opportunities for economic cooperation. Even though there might be some people who might be in disagreement in that type of relationship, the goal is for economic growth and development, and to kind of forget about the whole thing about ideologies here. Let's look at it from a realistic point of view and consider that, you know, this relationship in some form of way is developing some form of economic activity. So now I just want to now transition to the historical relevance and domestic affairs development within the country. So to fully grasp Kenya's current state and its role in the global economy, we must delve into historical relevance and domestic affairs development. Kenya's history is deeply rooted in ancient civilizations and tribal communities that have inhabited the region for centuries. The colonial era, as it's called, marked by the British rule, brought significant changes to Kenya's social political landscape. The introduction of cash crops like tea, coffee, as well as development of transportation infrastructure contributed to the country's economic transformation. However, the colonial period was also characterized by tensions and resistance from local population, as famously known as the Mau Mau Uprising, which sought to challenge British rule and fight for independence. Kenya eventually gained independence on December 12th, 1963, and it's considered Jamhuri Day. And this allowed Kenya to embark on a journey of self-determination and nation building. So Kenya's economic influence and political implications are related to its domestic affairs. Kenya's domestic affairs development intertwines with its regional role. The country actively participates in regional organizations like East African Community, which is called the EAC, and the African Union, working towards economic integration, peacekeeping efforts, and regional stability. Kenya's vibrant private sector, entrepreneurial spirit, and diverse industries contribute to its economic influence. The country has attracted foreign direct investments and positioned itself as a hub for innovation and technology, particularly with the rise of its Silicon Savannah in Nairobi. Despite progress, Kenya faces challenges such as corruption, income inequality, and ethnic tensions, which is really big. Efforts have been made to address these issues through anti-corruption initiatives, constitutional reforms, and inclusive policies to promote equitable development and social cohesion. Chege, in 2018, shed light on the economic relations between Kenya and China, emphasizing the historical context and implications for U.S.-China-Africa cooperation. So now I'm going to transition into now. We now have an overview and an understanding of Kenya's economic growth, activity, and development, its international trade relations. Now I'm going to transition into the importance of advancing equitable access to higher education. So in addition to its economic growth, Kenya is committed to advancing equitable access to higher education, bridging African-American history, international administration, and East African development. Recognizing the importance of education in driving social economic progress, Kenya has taken significant strides to expand access to higher education. Initiatives such as scholarships, grants, and partnerships with international institutions aim to provide opportunities for students from diverse backgrounds. I'm hoping one day I can also be part of that realm of society to advance higher education within the country. This commitment also extends to exploring the rich history and contributions of African Americans, fostering cultural exchange and understanding. Through international administration collaboration, Kenya seeks to leverage expertise and best practices to enhance its education system and drive sustainable development. So the effect of international remittances on economic growth will be the next part I talk about after talking about advancing equitable higher education things. So international remittances play a vital role in Kenya's economic growth, further strengthening its position in global economy. There's research by Mwangi and Mwende in 2015 indicates that international remittances have a positive effect on Kenya's economic growth. Money sent by Kenyan diaspora abroad contributes to household income, boosts consumption, and supports various sectors of the economy. This influx of remittances, can't even say the word today, has a multiplier effect, driving economic activities and contributing to Kenya's overall development. As Kenya continues its journey of growth and development, it remains essential for the nation to harness its rising influence and leverage its trade relations, infrastructure advancements, and commitment to equitable access to higher education. By capitalizing on these strengths and addressing the challenges at hand, Kenya can shape a prosperous future for its people and make significant contributions on the global stage. So I've explored Kenya's economic significance, trade relations, regional implications, and the pursuit of equitable education. So I hope you can join me next time as I delve into another captivating topic, unveiling the dynamic landscape of the global economy. And thank you so much for listening, and I hope you learned something for this. And remember, stay true to yourself and keep exploring. And also, again, always remember, pursue your dream and seize the day. Peace out.